Well, Mark and George went to go retrieve Mark's bull, and Casey and I went on a mission to find the deepest, darkest hellhole we could in search of elk. I think we found it. We found one, what we think is a really nice bull, but the wind blew us. Meanwhile, we found this nice little piece of paradise down here. A little water source, smack on the side of a really steep hillside. Chef Peter, what do we have here?
We got grouse and elk nuts. And for any, all you people that never eaten elk nuts, you will never throw them away again if you can prepare it correctly.
George and Mark are going to retrieve some mules. They got scattered last night when some dirt bikers came through the camp. And Casey and I are heading up the mountain. See if we can't kill us an elk today. You know the problem with going in deep, dark places?
We gotta come out of them.
Absolutely.
Just these two?
Yeah, because I think we're leaving the
the mules.
Yeah, they don't get nothing. So just Sally and him.
Yep. Yep. Your horse is all right? Did you rode today?
Yeah, he's fine.
Green there, red rider.
Heading out for another morning.
Hang time, Mark. Yes, that's it. We're gonna do it.
Well, after all that action this morning, bull finally got her scent. Should say the cows got her scent. Took off up over the ridge. So we got on the horses and rode around the mountain, and George dropped in on the bull basin where we're pretty sure they went. He's gonna go try to kill that. Casey and I are gonna head to a different drainage, see what we can find there. Another early morning, getting the horses ready. We've got a bull spotted. He's moving in, so we're trying to get in front of him. So we've been hanging out in one drainage over from where this bull is for 3 hours. The winds are way too inconsistent. We got a really heavy cloud cover, high winds up top. Every 5 minutes the wind changes direction. There's no way we can sneak in on him. So we're gonna leave him be, head back to camp, graze the horses, try to come back maybe tomorrow. Hopefully he's still there with better winds. 5 a.m. Heading out for the morning.
An hour to me. I just want to go so bad. Oh, I love it. Tell the story.
Okay, guys. Sorry we didn't film any of this, but we were in bull killing mode. So Mark spotted a toad bull in this drainage that we've been watching. And he covered across that drainage, moved into the timber underneath us, and we set up. Mark did what? A handful of cow calls?
Yeah.
And he answered. We moved down the hill 200 yards towards him. He fired off again, and he was coming. I mean, I didn't even take my backpack off. We set up, and I just stuck this bull at 30 yards. So now's the wait. He was, I don't know, what is this, a 30 degree downhill angle?
Oh yeah, it's steep.
And he was quartered to me hard. So I hugged the shoulder blade high and basically hit him right at the top of the shoulder blade. I got about half my arrow penetration. So a good 16 inches maybe. And we'll see. I don't think there's gonna be any blood on this. This is gonna be hell of a track. We're gonna have to follow his footsteps or his tracks, because there's not gonna be blood. I shot him so high, but I'm hoping I got that long. So stay tuned.
Wait it out.
Well, it's been almost 2.5 hours now since I shot that bull. We've been sitting here waiting. I wanted to give him lots of time because my shot was a little high. He was quartered to me, and my rangefinder does the angle compensation. So I went back and I ranged to the spot to where he was standing, and it was at 31 yards, and I held on my 30 yard pin, and my rangefinder said it's 29 degree angle. So I don't know, we're on a pretty steep hillside, so my shot was high and forward, but I think with the angle, it should be about right. I'd hit that offside lung, but since it wasn't a perfect shot, I wanted to give this bull lots of time. So it's been about 2.5 hours. We're gonna go start tracking. Well, this has been a very tough track job. We've gone 1 hour and 20 minutes so far, following nothing but tracks, and finally found our very first blood. He ran by this bush, and as you can see, there's, hopefully you can see that, this thing is coated with blood. And he just smeared the side of it as he went by. Well, I'm feeling pretty down right now. It's 6 o'clock. It's been about 7 hours since I shot that bull. And sort of going back over it. I think I hit him high, basically in the wither, right top of the shoulder. There's nothing vital there. We trailed him for a mile. We let him rest. We gave him 2 hours before we started tracking. Found my arrow, had about a foot of penetration, maybe a little more, about half the arrow shaft. And he went over a half a mile. We were just following tracks before we found any blood, and it was just blood high on a branch that had rubbed off when he went by it. And he went another quarter mile. He ran into another group of elk and just scattered them. There were tracks everywhere. Took us a long time to figure out which ones were his. We finally found just one more blood, same situation, high on a branch that he rubbed off on him. I think it's just surface blood, you know, dribbling out the top of his wither there. And we continued tracking him. So 6 hours later, finally had to give it up. We sort of lost his tracks. The elk were just scattered. There's so many elk tracks where he went. I know the basin he went right down into the same drainage where I shot at that 5-point on the first day and nicked the top of the stub on that stump or on the tree, and my arrow went right over the top of him. He's headed right down into that same drainage, so I'm not giving up yet. I'll go back in tomorrow and see if I can find him in there. So I'm still looking for that bull that I arrowed. We found his tracks yesterday. We found his bed. We rode the horses up within about 150 yards of his bed, and unfortunately didn't realize it. and jumped him up, and so we let him rest yesterday. I came back this morning, once I got the thermals right, I'm back on his tracks and I'm following him. And so far I'm, I don't know, maybe half mile, thousand, maybe 1,000 yards, I guess, under where he bedded, where we kicked him up. And I just found his bed again, where he spent the night, last night. So I'm just gonna stay on his tracks. He's going straight downhill. Well, it's now 1 o'clock, 2 days after I shot that bull, and I've been on his tracks. I found his last night's bed. He hooked up with some cows up on it. There's 3 or 4 cow beds there, fresh poop, his bed. They spent quite a bit of time milling around there. Then he followed the cows out, looped back up to basically where he'd been. He's going back uphill now. This bull's not, he's not that injured. Unfortunately, I think I just made a bad shot. He's going uphill, he's covering country, he's chasing cows. I've tried to get him to answer cow call, but he's not being vocal, but he's in this area here somewhere, he's not leaving. I think I've done about all I can do here, 2 days of looking, and I tell you what, his tracks have been hard to follow, especially last night with the frozen ground. They weren't hardly leaving much of an imprint, and I did really good until I found his bed with all those cows, and there's just such a jumble there, I can't tell which, you know, I can tell his track, but I can't tell where, there's so many of them over top of each other, I can't tell where they went from there. So, guess I'm done. So yesterday, while I was looking for my bull, Casey shot another 6-point. Rolled in about 10 o'clock last night, and we were up till about midnight getting the quarters hung and getting them unloaded, so that makes 2 for the trip. Sorry I don't have any of it on film. Well, we got the 4 mules saddled. We're gonna head out this morning with a load of meat, 2 elk, half an elk on each mule. Come back in tonight. Got about a 20-mile day in front of us.
Go ahead and take it down all the way.
Taking 2 bulls back to the truck. A little frosty out this morning, but we're breaking camp. Built a big fire and burning some of our garbage.
You still the tent?
Yeah. I was just gonna pack that bag out here.
Yeah.
Down, loaded on the mules. Just getting our saddle horses ready to go. And we'll be out of here. All right, another successful elk camp. Elk Camp 2020, officially over. Oh, bud. Whoa.
Line out. Line out. Back dip. Line out.
Ooh.
Heads up.
Wait your turn. Whoa. Well, this was personally a very frustrating hunt for me, not being able to recover the bull I shot. I have to remember that it's the experiences that matter most. I had the pleasure of spending 2 weeks in beautiful country doing something I love with good friends. Who can complain about that? We told lots of stories, laughed, worked hard, and got to forget about all the pressures of work, politics, COVID, and all the other craziness going on in the world. For 2 weeks, life became simple, spending time with good friends in the elk woods. I hope you enjoyed watching. Supposed to be the light ones, George.